People in Iran have been following the U.S. election closely. The country's leaders are hoping President-elect Biden will mean a better chance for improved relations with the U.S. CBS News senior foreign correspondent Elizabeth Palmer reports.
Every shopping trip here is a reminder of punishing U.S. sanctions. Prices are up and the value of money has shrunk. Joe Biden's win offers weary Iranians a glimmer of relief, says our Tehran producer Saeed Rahim Batai.
What they are looking for, if it is even a little breeze of changes, hope for future.
People hope President-elect Biden will engage with Iran and revisit the nuclear deal that President Trump pulled out of in 2018. In return, they want at least some relief from painful sanctions.
Almost every groceries that a family might need for an everyday life, it was hurting people. And of course, medicine and medical equipment, which could and has already led to people dying.
Like I've read, insulin?
Medicine for cancer, different types of cancers, and also medical equipment. CAT scans.
Even Iran's president, Hassan Rouhani, said he hoped the U.S. would return to what he called its obligations, that is, the nuclear deal, which Iran considers still alive. Much foreign news is censored here, but Iranians have had a look at the future U.S. president and are reassured.
How do Iranians see Mr. Biden? What characteristics have they picked up on?
I think they see him as a more serious, calm, someone who would listen to science, would listen to experts, and wouldn't take decisions like overnight, all of a sudden. So they think things will calm down in the U.S., which eventually might lead for a better relations with Iran.
Do they comment on the fact that he is old?
Definitely that's not a big issue over here. People don't think it that way.
But you have your own old leaders, so you're used to it.
Yes, well, we have some old leaders too. So, no, that's not a big issue over here.
Very interesting.
Even he might seem a little bit young compared to them.
Relations between the two countries are so toxic right now, improvement isn't going to come anytime soon. But this long-suffering nation knows how to wait. Elizabeth Palmer, CBS News, Tehran.